Why Ancient Symbols Are Demonized. Published on April 28, 2015, by Carl Donk. Throughout history, important knowledge has very often been kept secret by groups of people who wanted to keep the masses ignorant and docile, so that they could easily be controlled, manipulated, and enslaved. In the cases where this knowledge couldn't be repressed, the information was either manipulated so that it lost its true meaning, or was demonized, portrayed as wicked and threatening, and often made illegal so that the people would fear it and automatically stay away from it. This is the case with many of the very ancient symbols, such as the all-seeing eye. Like I discussed in the past, a lot of knowledge is compressed and encoded in these simple symbolic visual representations, important knowledge concerning the fundamental nature of the reality we live in. Knowing their true meaning unleashes true power for the individual, who then cannot be enslaved anymore. For example, ask yourself why the all-seeing eye can be found inside so many churches and cathedrals around the world, while its true meaning is unknown to most of the people who attend. Instead of being told the truth, why are the masses made to worship a fake figure on a cross? Why aren't they told that this fake figure on the cross is a symbolic representation of the sun? Why is this information being withheld from the public? Consider that it was even worse in the past. Just a few centuries ago, it was even illegal for people to own a copy of the Bible and read it themselves. Those at the top of these organizations do know what these symbols mean, of course, and that knowledge is often used against the masses. The masses have been kept in the dark on purpose for thousands of years, either through a lack of information, or misleading, and even completely false information. But like I discussed in my post on the global brain, we're heading into an age now where it's going to become increasingly more difficult to suppress knowledge and to keep the masses in the dark. The mentally dead are now waking up. As a result of this awakening, the Zionist-controlled Hollywood has been abusing these symbols in their movies and entertainment in the last few years. Through their propaganda, these symbols are being connected with superficial information and disinformation in the mind of the public. The elite have realized that they cannot suppress and demonize these symbols any longer, and their strategy has now changed to making them superficial and spreading disinformation about them. The knowledge that's encoded in these ancient symbols isn't evil in and of itself, it's how you use it that matters. Take a hammer, for example. A hammer can be used to build things, but it can also be used to destroy. It can be used both for positive and negative purposes. The fact that someone can use a hammer for negative purposes doesn't mean that it's intrinsically a dangerous or evil tool. The same goes for the knowledge encoded in the ancient symbols. That knowledge can be used both for good and evil purposes. And when the masses are completely ignorant of that knowledge, they become especially vulnerable in the hands of the small elite, who are aware of that knowledge and don't have the best interests of the masses in mind. Whenever you notice that something is being demonized, repressed, and/or made illegal, that should be a clear sign that you probably should take a look at it and investigate it thoroughly. This not only goes for the ancient symbols and knowledge, but also for people such as Adolf Hitler and Muammar al-Qaddafi, who have been demonized by the Zionist-controlled mainstream media. Even Nelson Mandela was once demonized and seen as a terrorist when it benefited the agenda of the elite. The same can be said about cannabis, also known as hemp or marijuana, a wonder plant with many industrial uses, and the ability to cure a large number of diseases, including cancer. It too was demonized and made illegal by the elite so the public wouldn't be able to benefit from it. And the same can also be said about our sexuality, which for thousands of years has been repressed and demonized in order to frustrate our lives so it would be easier to enslave us. That's why Dr. Sigmund Freud had mentioned to Carl Jung that his sexual theories, which had uncovered exactly how we were being manipulated through our sexuality, had to be defended from the black tide of occultism. You see, knowledge has to be made occult, or has to be demonized, in order to continue to be able to abuse it and use it against the masses. If the masses aren't aware of that knowledge, it becomes impossible for them to realize exactly how it's used against them, and consequently, much more difficult for them to defend themselves. Thank you for listening. This article was originally published on Carl Donk's blog at blog.carldonk.com. Remember to visit for regular updates. You can also find this content published on archive.org and lbry.tv. Remember to save a local copy of this video and any other content that you would like to continue to have access to in the future. You never know, those motherfuckers in big tech might censor this content in the future.